What's good, arm wrestling fans? I'm Pradeep from Arm Wrestling Noobs. Welcome to my channel. Larry Wheels versus Schoolboy. After 6 months of build-up, this match finally happened on 28th of October, and man, did that thing got exciting towards the end. First of all, my predictions went horribly wrong about this match. If you haven't watched this video yet and don't want any spoilers from me, then stop this video here. I'll give you the link to the original video in the description. I thought they would make a deal to make this match look more exciting, and Schoolboy will concede at least one round to Larry, and the score would be 3-1 or 4-1 depending on the rule set. But these Russian kids, man, highly professional, didn't give a thing to Larry. So let's talk about the match itself. Larry said, and I quote, "This is not for marketing and it is going to be an all-out serious match." Sergio was the referee of the match. The rules were WAF plus running fouls. 5 rounds total, first 3 with the straps and last 2 without straps. So Schoolboy gave everything that Larry needed. But you can see that Schoolboy was kind of being safe here and ensuring his win in the last 2 rounds. So he kind of took Larry seriously. The first round took way too long to start, 35 seconds to be precise, to get a set grip. And this is exactly where Larry lost this match, even before it started. And for you guys complaining about Khalid bullying Schoolboy in the setup, Schoolboy took 35 seconds to grip with Larry. So basically he did the same thing till he was sure that Larry had nothing for him. Because in the next 4 rounds, he hardly took 2 seconds to grip up. So don't hate on Ava. You gotta do what you gotta do to win, man. Anyways, next 4 rounds, Schoolboy gave Larry everything. He hooked him, he top rolled him, he allowed him to engage his power, and still dominated the match. Not saying that Larry could have beat him by any means, but the setup in the first round is something that he needs to practice. So the result was 5-0, Larry accepted the defeat, and just when I thought that Larry may quit arm wrestling after this humbling defeat, something exciting happened. Come on, Schoolboy, Ava wasn't gonna let you go without having a go at it. And before we discuss this match, I want to address the hate that Ava has been getting recently. People say that he has ego problems and he's an idiot and much more. I have one question for you all. When did the unwillingness to lose and win at all costs attitude started being called ego problems? Sportsmanship and being nice to others was a gesture of kindness a few decades ago. And now, the soft people with their soft language and behavior have made being nice a necessary attribute that everyone must possess. Ava beats his Schoolboy, he's an idiot. Why does he need to pretend to be nice to others if he's not that kind of person? Last time I checked, there was no rule in any country that forces someone to be nice to others. Devon Larratt also said that the statement that Ava has a bad ego cannot be further from truth. He's a nice sportsman.
About Khalid saying he's a bad sportsman and he's got a big ego, which I'll tell you right off the bat, could not be further from the truth. If you don't have an ego or a strong desire to win, good luck making it in competitive arm wrestling.
So it's a request to you guys, please stop hating him. Anyways, turning back into the match. During this time, I saw something that no one has ever talked about, or something that according to me happened for the first time in arm wrestling history. A beginner with 2 months of arm wrestling dominating and bullying a pro in the setup. Beginners have defeated pros before, but it is always a pro who dominates the setup. So after 20 seconds of Khalid squeezing the life out of Schoolboy's thumb, the referee says go, Schoolboy hits and Khalid catches his hit and absolutely buckles his wrist back. And then Schoolboy bails out with an intentional underhand slip. That's when Schoolboy's facial expressions changed and the match was over. The same thing that happened to Larry before round 1. If you remember Artem's interview with Devon on his channel Top Roll King Productions, Devon said that if Larry gets aggressive in the setup and doesn't allow Schoolboy to get a nice grip, then he's in the match.
Like, if Larry is somehow able to set up on par, like if he is really aggressive in that set and if he gets some kind of neutral ground and it's for a second able to come down a horsepower, woo, we got ourselves a match.
He even did the exact same thing that Devon does when he pulls and pins his opponent's arm when the referee is trying to start the match. Second time again, he held on to his thumb and schoolboy barely escaped. Third time, Sergio asked the schoolboy for the straps, but he said nothing. And guys, if you haven't watched the 50 minutes grip strength video that Larry posted a week ago, you must watch it to understand how strong Khalid's fingers are. Just to give you an insight, any grip exercise that he tried, he was within world record ranges. That kind of explains why no one is able to slip against him outside of his straps. Later, Alex revealed that his schoolboy did injure his thumb while trying to slip. Anyways, finally they get to the straps, and schoolboy was absolutely shitting himself by this time. He was out of breath, sweating heavily, and all the signs of paralyzing nervousness. And Khalid pinned him easily. I read someone's comment who said Alexander was sore. Fresh for fresh, he would beat Khalid. Schoolboy didn't have any match right-handed before this, and left-handed he himself said that he didn't even feel Larry's power. Okay, enough said in support of Khalid. This was a completely new situation for a schoolboy. He's only 20 years old, guys. And when he got bullied and saw dozens of people cheering for Khalid, it's quite natural to get nervous in such a situation. Kudos to that strong kid. After that, Larry saw an opening and jumped into the situation. And his right arm suddenly got healed up. Larry used sneaky Schoolboy tried his deepest under the table Kings move out of desperation. But since his elbows aren't as jacked up as Michael Todd or Devon Larratt, Larry was able to pin him twice. It was an amazing move from Larry. It added immensely to the content of this video and a future hope for Larry that he might actually be able to do something against him. Alex from Arm Wrestling TV commented that he is looking for a schoolboy versus Larry right-handed super match in WAL. Ryan Bowen uploaded a video after this match. He is talking with Larry's manager for 4 super matches. Him versus Khalid right and left-handed. Lachlan Adair versus Larry right and left-handed. We get it, Ryan. Lachlan is your friend. But trying to make him arm wrestle the entire world? The travel restrictions haven't been lifted yet. Cannot go out of their states. Toddzilla match is not confirmed yet. And there you are again trying to talk Lachlan into a match. But this time his standards have kind of dropped from Toddzilla to Larry Wheels. Anyways guys, give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends. My name is Pradeep, and I thank you so much for watching.